Hey guys, have you ever wondered why some restaurants can charge $5 a burger, whereas some other restaurants can charge $12 a burger for the same exact burger? And the answer is all in branding. Today, I'm going to be covering the four essential steps on how do you do restaurant branding for your restaurant so then that way you can have a very, very profitable business, so then that way you can afford to bring your family on travel and not being stuck at your restaurant pulling your hair out all the time. If you are in the process of building a restaurant or you're already in the restaurant business, make sure you guys keep watching. My name is Wilson, serial entrepreneur, owner of multiple seven-figure businesses. Make sure you guys subscribe along the journey because I'm going to be sharing with you a lot of tips, hacks, and even strategies on how do you scale and grow a profitable restaurant business. Without further ado, let's dive right into what is branding. Branding is not just your logo, okay? So many people actually always focus tremendous amount of time on their logo because it's the most sexiest thing to do. And I can tell you that branding is not just your logo. Branding is everything but just your logo, okay? We're talking about how people feel. We're talking about all the different touch points. We're talking about when people talk about your restaurant, when they go to your restaurant, when they see your restaurant, when they interact with your staff, when they look at your menu, when they go to the washroom, when they eat your food, and even when they leave the restaurant and talk about your restaurant after 2 weeks. This is all branding. Branding is basically a feeling of people, how people react to the experience that you want to deliver to your customers. So, once again, a lot of people focus only on their logo and expect that they have established a very, very good branding. And no, that's not the case. It's not just the designs, it's not just that. It is about the whole overall experience. So you may be wondering, what are the different parts of branding? Since it's not just the logo, it's not just the overall feeling. Branding includes your colors, the font style that you use, the images, the signages, the interior decor of your restaurant, staff uniforms, your menu, websites, social media, even the music that you play in your restaurant. All of these play an amazing role, an integral role in the branding of your business. So many people fail in branding because they only focus on one aspect. They only focus on their logos. They only focus on the sexy stuff. They only focus on things that not really a lot of people, other people focus on. True success in branding is being able to tell a story, a cohesive story. So any point that people interact with your brand, they have this consistent feeling, this consistent theme that you're able to portray. That is true branding, and that's how you're going to be able to demand a higher premium on your menu items, thus making you much more profitable. So now that we talked about the importance of branding and what is branding for a restaurant and the different components that play into restaurant branding, now we're gonna dive into the four essential steps to build your brand so then that way you can have success at your restaurants. Number one thing that you're able to achieve through branding for your restaurant is brand loyalty. Now, what is brand loyalty? It is this intangible feeling, intangible force that pushes your customers to come back again and again to your restaurant, which is the reason why if you can, and if you are paying attention, you can actually craft this experience, this intangible feeling, this force that gravitates your customers to your restaurant. Without further ado, we are gonna dive into step number one, and that number one is to define your core values. What does it mean to define your core values? It is the principle of what you truly believe in. Why is it super important to be able to define and tell the world what you truly believe in and what you stand for? It is because you are a leader within your realm and you are a leader within what you're trying to serve and portray out in the world. If you're not clear with that, people cannot attach them to your cause. They cannot attach themselves to you. And it is okay to have different values for your organization, what you are, and more importantly, what you are not. So to give you an example, with 720 Suites, something that we truly value is innovativeness. And what that means is that we always create things that are innovative because we are known for the brand that is hype. We're known for the brand that appeals to the millennial, to the students. And what they want are Instagrammable friendly pictures and Instagrammable stuff. Because why do they want to do that? They want to belong in their group. They want to be able to share good stuff. with their friends and family. So that's what we stand for. And that dictates basically all our product development. That dictates the way we design our shop is in the forefront. It is modern, it is fun. These are the things that we are super, super intentful with. And because of the fact that this is a value that we have defined, all the millennials within the University of UBC, they all know of us as being that innovative brand. And because we have identified ourselves with this value, people who value these things would come to us. People that are looking for that next thing, people looking for the hype item, people who really appreciate nicely decorated ice creams would come to us and our shop because they understand this is exactly what we can provide them. So many people are afraid to declare their own values because they're afraid to push people that do not believe the same thing away. They're afraid to be able to take a stand because they're afraid of the opinions of others, that they're not going to match with others. And I'm just giving you permission to actually declare that. I'm telling you that it's okay, because when you put a stand in something and you put a stand and define clearly what your values are, you're gonna be able to push away the people that don't believe in it, but you're gonna be able to attract that loyal base of customers. You're gonna be able to attract the people who believe in it. And just like in the dating world, you don't attract every single one out there. You attract the people that believe in what you believe in. You attract the people who appreciate you for who you are. And that's exactly the same thing with running a business. You gotta be able to define your values so then people would know whether they wanna gravitate towards you or choose someone else. And the people that gravitate towards you, they're gonna become much, much more loyal customers to you. And that is much more valuable as a loyal customer than someone that just comes in for a transactional meal. And the second step in creating this irresistible restaurant of yours is crafting a story. Why is crafting a story super important? It is because everyone loves a story. People are gravitated to stories because it just tugs on their heartstrings. That's why everyone loves Marvel. Everyone loves movies. They love the fact that there's always a conflict. There's always something to solve. And for you, you need to be able to identify what is that problem that you want to solve. What is that conflict within your journey that made you create this restaurant? And by you being able to identify that and providing the solution as a result of this conflict and being able to win from this, being able to declare, prevail from this hardship, this is what is inspiring for your customers. This is what's gonna be able to connect with your customers. This is how you're gonna be able to gain brand loyalty by identifying and crafting a story for your restaurant concept, for your business. The third step in branding your restaurant for success is to identify your customers. So many people don't identify their customers. They have a product, they push it out in the market and expect people to fall in love with it. That's not how it goes. Unfortunately, that's just not how it goes. You need to identify your customer. You need to understand who you're crafting your product and who you're serving to, because everyone has different profiles. Everyone has different desires when they come into a restaurant. Whether it be an office person that just wants something healthy, they want something quick, they want something grab and go. Yet, why are you offering them a meal that takes 30 minutes to make and it's a fine dining experience? It doesn't work like that. You need to identify your customers and you need to identify their needs. You need to understand what are they doing, their social media platform, where exactly they are hanging out on, and then providing something that fits exactly what they need to be done, okay? So for example, with 720 Sweets, we're selling ice cream. Obviously, we know we appeal to people after lunchtime. We appeal to people after dinner time. We need to appeal to people, the younger demographic, the millennials who are going to school. What do? They're always on Instagram. What do we provide? We provide an Instagrammable friendly environment. Not only is the product Instagrammable friendly, but also all the decor within our environment is equally as Instagrammable friendly, all because we understand our customer demographic. And in turn, we were able to have lineup out the doors because people love coming to our place, they love the feeling of it. They love that it's clean. They love that it's modern. They love the fact that they can take pictures, hang out with their friends, and equally feel belonged. So next time that you're crafting your restaurant experience, make sure you're able to identify who is it that you're serving. Is it some blue collar people that you wanna make sure that you provide them value after value after value? Because blue collar people, they want to have their stomach full. They wanna have their stomach full. They wanna be in, they wanna be out. They want beer. And these are all stereotype stuff that I'm providing you. But when it comes down to it, after you have an assumption of the people you wanna serve, go out there and validate, ask these people, go survey them, ask them what is it that they're looking for, ask them why is it that they're coming in. Are they coming in to wine and dine their other half, or are they coming in for a quick meal, or they just wanna come and chill and hang out with their friends? Understand your customer demographic. And then we're gonna go into the fourth step, which is the sexiest part, which is the funnest part, and that is to pull everything together and communicating and pushing it out to the world, and that is designs. The fourth and final step to be able to pull everything together is design, as I mentioned. It is only after that you have identified your values, not after you have identified your story, after you have identified your demographic. That's when you focus on the designs. Design is how you're able to communicate all these essential core pieces to your customers, and that's what your customers see. Design itself is not just fixated in the visual aspect as what we're talking about. It is the feeling. What do you want people to feel? If you want them to feel that they're in the place that belongs, then make sure that the lighting is perfect, the wood decors are warm and nice, and the food itself is comforting. That itself is an overall experience, an overall branding experience. And designs are able to help with that. Fixating only on the logo before you have identified your customer demographic, before you have identified their core values, before you have a story to tell, really serves no purpose, because you do not have consistency in what language and what kind of things and message you want to portray to your customers. Consistency is one of the key elements when it comes to design. So imagine you walking into a restaurant, looking at their menu, and the logo is different from the logo that is on their wall. And the message that it says on there, what they support and their values, is completely different from what you see in their decor. Then that itself creates a lot of conflict, and conflict makes people confused. And when people are confused, they're not gonna buy into what you have to say, which is the reason why it is super, super important for us to identify the first three steps before we work on designing and pulling everything together. Without further ado, we're gonna be talking about the different components of designs that we need to pay attention to. As I was saying, logo is not everything, but logo is also a very, very important part of design asset. And today I'm gonna cover a few different assets. These are the essential branding assets that you definitely need for your restaurant. And the first one is logo. Logo is basically what people see in the very, very first time they interact with your brand. And it should give them a certain feeling. It should be able to portray that this is your restaurant. Just like that, whenever we think about the Golden Arcs, this is the M, right? What do we think of? We think about McDonald's, and that's precisely what we're trying to create, that feeling that is attached to the Golden Arcs. And there are a lot of different options out there to create logos. We can go from anywhere from like $150 to like $3,000 just to create a logo. And these guys are like agencies or like freelancers. And a lot of times I would only recommend going with design agencies or freelancers if you have the budget to do so, because they're a little bit on the pricier side, but they do an amazing job. I myself use freelancers all the time for all the businesses that I create, because I truly see the value in branding. Whereas if you want something that's a little bit more affordable, actually a lot more affordable, then you can look at AI generated logos and stuff like that. There's tons of options out there, and it is equally as good sometimes, right? They have faster turnover times, and they also are a lot more affordable. A brand that I love using is Taylor Brands. They're an amazing company because not only are they AI technology that helps you generate your logo, but then their support is just out of the world. Every time I message them, they always have support that sends it back. And for me, if I'm looking for something that is a quick turnaround thing and something that is super affordable, then I will always turn to Taylor Brands. Their website is very, very easy to use and is something that I highly, highly recommend you to check it out. Check out in the link below. That's where you're gonna get some discounts off if you decide to use them, because it's something that, once again, I highly, highly recommend. Now, let me walk you through the process of how they actually work. So now we are diving right into how we can use Taylor Brands as a website to create your own design assets. So for example, if you have a company called Will's Burger, just type in the name, press design, and automatically it will populate for you, basically, and ask you what industry you're in. So now we write burger, and then in the description, we just need to tell them, like, what are we specifically doing? Now we're gonna write small burger shop selling quality family products, or like friendly service. No, actually, quality family products and friendly service, something along the lines of that. And then we click next. Not that it really matters, but it's just a little bit more descriptive, the better. Now, after we write everything down, we see that they have generated a ton of icons for us to choose from. So this is where you're able to choose. Let's say if you have a burger shop, you can choose your burgers here. Or let's say if you have a drinks, a beverage shop, or let's say if you have a ramen shop, you can actually just click it in there to find your specific icon. For example, if I type in fast food, you can see a ton of different other icons would pop up. And this allows you to be a little bit more creative with what you're offering to the public. Now we're gonna go back up, change it back to burgers, because I like burgers, because this is called Will's Burgers. I'm gonna choose a simple one right here. Actually, you know what? Let's choose the juicy one. I think that's the one that I'd like to go with. But as you can see, using Taylor Brands allowed you to actually choose the one you like. They give you tons of variation, and this whole process is just super, super simple. Now we click next, and this is where we get to choose the font that resembles our logo. There's two to choose from, and basically we want to choose the one that you would prefer based upon the two examples. So then that way we can shortlist the ones that we like. And as you can see, they're pitching it against different examples. I like the thick, bald ones because I feel like that's more like, you know, manlier. So that's the reason why we're choosing that one. And this would allow us to shortlist the logo that we like. And as you can see, your logo is populating within the last, you know what, 2 minutes that we're shooting this video. And yeah, there you go. That's the logo, that's what's showing up, that's what shows up on Facebook, the design assets for, let's say, merchandises, Facebook, t-shirts, bags, everything. And on the left-hand side, you can actually scroll and see different variations of the logo, which is so amazing because this whole thing is generated by AI, and you can actually see for yourself within just 5 minutes how you can actually design all the branding assets for your F&B. And this itself takes out a lot of pressure from you to hire designers that cost you, what, $500-$600 per logo. Now you get to see so much more. And on top of that, now that you figured out what you want to create, you can actually customize and tweak that specific logo. And on the left-hand side, you can see that you can actually select the font on the left-hand side and the tweaks you want to make to the fonts, right? You like the style, but something is a little bit off, right? Let's say the spacing is too close together. Now you can actually have the spacing a little bit more wider. And there's so much to play with, and it is so, so intuitive, this whole tool, which is the reason why I really like using Taylor Brands. And I highly recommend this brand to you, because if you're just starting off, you don't want to deal with people and different designers all the time, because it is a pain in the butt dealing with designers, and they're super expensive. Whereas Taylor Brands allows you to really, really customize to your needs in a matter of a few different clicks. Okay, as you can see here, now that we have decided we're gonna choose this logo, we can just easily click next, and it
prompts us to the payment schedule and or the payment page. And honestly, with choosing either basic or standard or premium, all these are very attractive price points. Even then, I think it's still super, super beneficial for you guys to go with Taylor Brands, because you know, you can't really beat having a logo created for you for only what, $60 a month, and all the different assets as well. And in addition to that, because of the fact that you are our subscriber and you're watching this video, we have an extra 30% off if you were to subscribe using Taylor Brands, linked in the section below, description below. So make sure you guys go down there, redeem your 30%.
The second branding asset that we're talking about is the website for the restaurant. Now, a lot of people talk about the website. It might seem like ages ago that people talk about it, that, you know what, people don't need their website because you can just have an Instagram page. Now let me share a stat with you. More than 90% of the people who decide to go to a restaurant, they check online. And out of the 90% that check online, 57% of them actually go onto the restaurant's website. We're talking about more than half of the people that research goes to the restaurant's website. So no, it is not a dinosaur thing. It is not a fossil thing. It is still very, very, very relevant in today's age. So if you do not have a properly made website, make sure you guys get one. It is where people go and check out what to eat, the location, the hours of operation, the menu, and just pictures in general. And this is a place where you're going to be able to attract people to come into your restaurant. And once again, this is only one of the touch points that you really, really need to be able to pay attention to. So if you guys do not have a website, make sure you guys get one. And if you guys don't want to get a website, then I'm going to ban you from my channel, because it is super, super necessary in order for you to have a successful restaurant. Okay, so go and get yourself a good website, a website that is compatible with your phone. So there are websites that don't look nice when people search on their mobile phone, but in today's world, everyone searches websites on their phones. Okay, so make sure that your website, talk to your web developer to make sure that you make the website that is responsive to your mobile. Now you may be thinking, how do you create a website? You can create your own website through Wix, through Squarespace, and these websites, you can actually go and create your own, or you can get agency, once again, or freelancers to create these websites for you. Once again, the agencies are gonna be much, much more expensive. We're talking about anywhere from $3,000 to $5,000 just to make a website. If you're a little bit more, on a budget-friendlier term, you can create your own through Wix, as I was saying, or Squarespace. These guys are a really, really good option, but if you're just not that technical, I guess, like sensitive or capable, then you should definitely consider Taylor Brands as well, because they would help you create your website as well. Someone that I highly recommend as well, someone that I've actually used, a company that has actually created a really good experience for us, but at the same time, very, very affordable as well. Once again, their customer service is just up there and it is super affordable. Check out the link below if you are considering using them, because you're gonna get an amazing discount with them. The third branding asset that you should consider is definitely your menu. Menu is an amazing, amazing tool in order for you to be able to actually push the sales revenue for your restaurant. A lot of people oversee this. A lot of people just, you know what, I have an item, I'm just gonna put it in the menu and hopefully it flies. No, menu engineering is super, super important. It actually makes or breaks your restaurant. Just imagine this. Did you know that supersizing your fries has brought more than $5 billion to McDonald's? And it is all because of how they have engineered that into their menu. They have engineered that not just in their menu, but also trained all their staff to say, hey, do you want to supersize? This has made them billions of dollars. So having said that, it's something that I definitely, definitely recommend you to be able to look into. But for the sake of this video, I'm not going to go into menu engineering. You guys can check out another video right here. Okay, I'm not sure if this is going to be up by then, but menu engineering allows you to prime your customers of what to order. A lot of times we go to restaurants and we see that, hey, you know what, this is the menu item, and then right below it, it's like, hey, do you want to have an add-on? And automatically we're just so primed to be like, sure, yeah, I'll have the add-on, or sure, yeah, I'll have a drink. And these are all intentionally crafted and engineered for you to spend more on their items that have high margin items. So make sure that you guys check it out and pay attention to your menu design. In the link below, I've actually attached 50 different templates of menu design, so then that way you guys can take inspiration from. Make sure you guys check it out in the link below. A lot of these research took us tons of time, me and Jason, tons of time to create. So if you guys appreciate this, make sure you guys smash the like button, okay? The final piece of design that I'm gonna be talking to you about is the interior decor. So in the last few different design elements that I've mentioned, it is super important for you to pay attention. These are the essential pieces which I want to make sure that I bring to your attention, because these are the most visually impacting items, okay? So interior is super, super important, whether it goes from the lighting to the wall mural to basically the signages around your store. It's super, super important because it just gives that experience to your customers, whether they want to come in to be wined and dined and to feel like this is an amazing place and that I love my other half. Then yeah, make sure that the lighting is dim, make sure that everything looks posh, and make sure that it's a pleasant experience for your customers. So interior design is super, super important. Spend the time to consult with people, either interior designer, or if you don't have that resource, then make sure that you Google online to see what types of things that you want to be able to put into your restaurant decor. A really, really good resource and a really good website that I usually use is Pinterest. Pinterest is an amazing resource for me to be able to get inspiration from on how do I design my internal decor for every franchises that we help open with 720 Suites. We actually hire a designer to help us. And every time I actually go onto the Pinterest, I pin all these different things that I like and enjoy, and I send it to my designer. And afterwards, they're gonna be able to churn out things that I truly enjoy and I think that my customers would like. Which brings everything back. We need to understand who our demographic is. Who is it that we're serving? We need to understand what message we want to be able to portray and tell our customers. We want to be able to portray what our values are. So then that way we can incorporate into the design, whether it be customer first, whether it be posh, whether it be fun. All these are being told by the designs of our restaurants. So there you go, the four essential piece in branding your restaurant for success, so then that way you can charge $12 a burger, so then that way you can have much more profits. And this all comes back down to being able to clearly identify your values, so then that way you put a stand of what you stand for, communicate that to your audience, right? Second of all is to tell a story. Telling a story allows you to be able to connect with your audience, and in turn, allows them to come back again and again to be able to win them from your customers. And third is to know your audience. Know exactly who you're serving to. Know what they like, what they desire, where they hang out. So then that way, last but not least, the designs that communicate and wrap everything together in order to tell the world your stories, your values, and what you stand for. And this is the four steps to branding your restaurant, so then that way you have tons of profitability. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you smash the like button. I'm gonna make much more videos like this for you, more tips, more strategies, so then that way you can run a successful restaurant business. Nonetheless, I really hope to see you guys soon. See you guys next week.